Today, let us discuss the important topic, early blight of tomato. The disease name is tomato early blight. Pathogen name will be the Alternaria solanea and common name early blight. The host of early blight will be like tomato, potato, eggplant or other Solanum family members. Coming to the systemic position of the early blight, kingdom fungi, phylum Ascomycota, class Dothiodiomycetes, order Pleosporales, family Pleosporaceae, genus Alternaria, species Solani. Let us see the occurrence and history and diversity of the early blight. How and what is the history of early blight? We will see in this slide. Early blight is caused by Alternaria solani, and Alternaria solania is the problematic in tomato production areas east of the Rocky Mountains and is generally not an issue in the less humid Pacific or intermountain regions. It has the symptoms like this is a common disease of tomato occurring on the foliage of any stage of the growth. We will see some of the points of the early blight of tomato. Let us see the pathogen description. The mycelium, which is septate and branched, haline in the beginning and the later it becomes darker in color. The conidia are 12 to 20 into 120 to 296 micrometer and are found singly or in chains of two. The conidiospores, which are present in the pathogen, are short and produces an obculcate or muriform shaped conidia with horizontal and vertical septation, and it is pointed at the distal end. Coming to the symptoms, this is the common disease of tomato occurring on the foliage at any stage of the growth, and the fungus attacks the foliage, which is causing the characteristic leaf spots and blight. Early blight is first observed on the plants as small black lesions, mostly on the foliage. The foliar symptoms of Alternaria solania generally occur on the oldest leaves and start as small lesions that are brown to black in color. First they start with the brown color and they turn to the black color, the symptom of the foliage. These leaf spots resemble the concentric rings. This is the main important point in the early blight to notice. There will be a concentric rings in the leaf spots, a distinguishing characteristic of the pathogen. This is the important point. Both the area around the leaf spot and the entire leaf may become yellow or chlorotic. Means it become the leaf spot will become entirely yellow or it turns to the chlorotic. Under some favorable conditions like warm weather with short or abundant dews, significant defoliation of the lower leaves may occur, leading to the sun scald of the fruit. We can observe the fruit will look like sun scald in the fruit, and the stem lesions are dark, slightly sunken and concentric in shape. The fruit spots are similar in appearance to those on leaves, brown with dark concentric circles. Mature lesions are typically covered by a black velvety mass of the fungal spores. This is the main important point which is in the disease. Here you can observe the leaf lesions of the Alternaria solania on the foliage. Here you can see first it is starting with the brown color and later it is turning to the black color. Here the stem lesion of Alternaria solania. First you can observe in the leaf and it may spread to the stem also. In the fruit of tomato, you can observe like sun-scald appearance of the fruit in the tomato with the early blight, and it is concentric. Let us see about spread of disease, mode of survival. The conidia and the mycelium in the soil or in debris of affected plants can remain viable for more than 17 months. Mode of spread. Primary spread by airborne conidia, secondary spread by infected plant debris. Let us see what is the epidemiology of the early blight disease of tomato. First point, dry warm weather with intermittent rain. It causes the early blight. Poor vigor, temperature at 25 to 30 degrees Celsius and poorly manured crop. These are the some of the epidemiology of the crop. Let us see the control measures and management of the early blight of tomato. What are the management practices like cultural methods and chemical methods? Let us see now. First, cultural methods. Cultural control. Clear infected debris from the field to reduce inoculum for the next year. Rotate to a non-solanaceous crop for at least 3 years. Removal and destruction of infected plant debris should be done because the spores which are lying in the soil are the primary source for the infection. First of all, we should remove and destruct the infected plant debris. Next, we can go for the chemical control. Very early spraying with Zinc or Kapton of 0.2% and repeat it for every 15 to 20 days gives more effective control on the early blight of tomato. By these methods, we can control the early blight of tomato.